Hello, hello, my lovely ladies. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I want to do a full face of Nabla products. I have almost a full face of Nabla Cosmetics products in front of me. I'm going to try them all on camera and I'm going to show you a bit of an overview of the brand. I want to showcase the brand a little bit more on my channel because I have been loving Nabla Cosmetics for years now. And I want to make sure that at the end of the video, you know where to start with this brand because I have a lot of stuff. So you can pick and choose what you want to try first. Okay, let's dive into Nabla. If this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anneke Riss and on my channel, I want to inspire you to use a little bit of color every day by creating fun, colorful looks, but keeping them a little less loud so that you can actually wear color every day. I also try out a lot of new makeup, especially from high-end and indie brands, because I just love that. That's just my jam. So if you want some inspiration on how you can keep color wearable, and if you want to know what is actually worth your time and money, then please consider subscribing. I would love to have you here. I upload 2 times a week, and sometimes I throw in a bonus video as well. All right, Nabla, I have a few things. I have a foundation, I have a bronzer, a blush, and a highlighter. I have an eyeshadow palette, I have eyeliners, and I have some lip products. So I have a few of the new lip liners, and I have it's a creamy, dreamy liquid lip thing. I'm going to start with the eyeshadow palette because I always do my eyes first, and then I do my base, so that is why I'm, you know, fresh face now. I'm going to put my hair up, I'm going to zoom you in a little, and then we're going to start off with the eyeshadow palette. This is the palette I am going to play with today. And as you can see, it's quite neutral. I love that Nabla is delving in a little bit more into neutrals. I am usually, as I said in my intro, I love colorful makeup. But I can also appreciate a very good neutral palette. And for Nabla, I have known Nabla as always having eyeshadow palettes that are colorful, having some neutral base shades so that you can ground the look, but overall you can say they're pretty colorful brands. So I love that they are dabbling into neutrals a little bit more because I think that can broaden their horizon, broaden their fan base, and I think that's a good thing. I am a little bit torn on what to do. You know what? I am feeling like doing a very dark taupe neutral look. So I want to make a look around this Love Ritual shade. Look, this is that shade. Need I say more? So I think I am going to build a look around that shade because I just really think it's stunning. I'm taking my MAC 217S brush and I'm going into Beauty Mark. That is this shade. Going to start in my outer corner and then work on my crease. And this is like a very murky color, as you can see. I have set my eyelid with some MAC Paint Pot in Paintly, and I set it with a little bit of a bone colored eyeshadow to make sure that I can blend the shades. I always do that. It is a beautiful shade, but I have a little bit of trouble blending because I have that like line. And as you see that like stripe going. So yeah, I never have that. Or that doesn't always happen. So I'm just going to touch it very lightly and try to blend more. It's a Wayfa 228 brush and I'm going into Halftime, the shade. I have to be careful because I think it's darker than it looks, but I want to blend this out a little bit. Ooh, it's way more yellow than I thought. Well, that's okay, I think. This shade blends really nicely. It's just that other shade that gave me a little bit of, well, I wouldn't say trouble, but I had to work a little harder. Usually I am not used to having to work a little harder with Nabla, but that's okay. Well, it's dark, it's sultry, and I love it. I'm taking my Sigma E27 brush and I'm going into Clan, this one. This is a beautiful brownish gray or grayish brown. Really nice. I'm going to very softly deepen up that outer corner a little bit. I can always add, you know, more when I need to. Wow, just stepping that on. Look at that. Ooh. Well, that was easy. Then next, I want to go into that shade I was talking about, that Love Ritual. I will keep keep it, I will put it a little bit close up. And I'm using my trusty Smith Arrowhead brush. This is the 253. And we're going to see, I'm not going to spray my brush just yet. I want to see what it does just on its own. Oh. Oh my god, this is why I love Nabla. Look at that, it's so beautiful. My gosh. I'm not going to spray my brush. This looks so beautiful already. This, oh my god, I love Nabla. Nabla is the best. Look at this. It's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. Yes, it's a neutral look, but it's not boring. I love that taupe. It has such dimension. I don't know if you can really see it, but there's some sort of like a pinkish tone to it as well. It's really beautiful. Stunning. All right, I want to do something with my inner corner. And the only thing I think is going to work is Ray of Light, this one. But I just saw that it has like this almost... I'm not flipping you off, I'm sorry. Like almost a... matte gold, like if you have like metal, like this type of metal, but then in an eyeshadow palette, which I think you don't hear me complaining. You don't hear me complaining about that. And having a shade like that in an eyeshadow palette, I love it. I just don't know for sure if it's gonna work with the taupe, but I am going to. I just cleaned my brush and I'm going to go into there just a little bit because I don't wanna have like that bold gold on my inner corner just yet. I just want to lighten it up a little bit. And I think, oh yeah, you can totally do that. Just take a little bit. You don't have to spray your brush. And just lay it on top of that like love ritual. Look. Look how beautiful that is. I think this look looks stunning. I would totally wear this to work. You know, beautiful. Really, really nice. But I want to deepen it up a little bit. So I am going to go back with my Sigma brush into that deep Glen color. And I'm going to deepen it up a little bit more to make it a little bit more sultry. Just very lightly, just stamping it on. Because I don't want to disturb like that beautiful love ritual shade. But I really want to deepen it up a little. All right, I think we have to do a line, but I only have these three, so I'm thinking, should I go for two or should I go for three? Let's swatch them, because the purple could be really cool, but I don't want to F this up, you know? Oh. What do you think? I think that the brown is the most safe bet, but do I want to play safe? No, I think the purple is not going to work. Okay, I am going with the darker brown. It's the number 2. And you have to remember with this, with these pencils, they are really soft and they have a very stubby point. You can sharpen them with this little thingy-me-jingy, but it's not going to be extremely sharp. So if you want to have a straighter line or very close to your lash line, then use a brush. And I think I will do that because I don't want to have it be too brown. I'm going to use my Smith 205 brush, but you can also use very easily. You have the Sigma, what's it? The E06. It's a very small brush. Or you can use the E65 by Sigma. Any of those two will also work. Okay, I'm going to just load the brush with a bit of the product on the pencil. Then I'm going to press it down on my hand like this to make it like a fine line. And then I'm going to very softly put it on my eye. Okay, like so. And then to finish it up, I want to give a little bit of light to my brow bone. And I think I'm going to use Rarity for that. That's the shade. And I'm going to use a Morphe, what's the thing? E36. I think these are really easy for detailed work. Just going to concentrate it on that like point where my arch is for my brow. And this is really nice. This is a nice color. It's not too light, but it really brightens up. And I think it always ties a look together if you do this step. All right, I'm going to put some mascara on and then we're going to go over to the face and we're going to do some foundation. Alright, I put on some mascara. I also put a little bit of that, like, what's it called? The Rarity, I think? Yeah. This shade, Rarity, I put it here, but I did it off camera. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to betray you like that, but I did a little bit off camera just to brighten it all up a little bit. I picked up a foundation. It's called the Nabla Close Up Futuristic Foundation. It says it's weightless. It's a liquid. It doesn't really say anything other than that, that it's weightless and that it's a soft focus. I got the mini size. It's a 30 mils. I got this shade. It's the L40. It might be a little bit too light for me, but I am known to pick out way too dark foundations. Normally, I would put some concealer on here just to, you know, even out the redness a little bit, but I really want to see what the coverage on this foundation is. So I'm just going to put it on like that. It's like this small squeezy thing. So I'm just going to put it on my palette. Okay. Yes. It's a little bit thicker than I thought. I'm taking this much and it's really yellow. I'm just going to put it a few dots of it with my fingers and then I'm going to blend it out with a sponge. Something like that. I'm going to take my beauty blender. I'm just going to put a little bit up its butt. Hey, I did say that. And then I'm going to stamp it in. I did put primer on my face. I will have the primers listed down below. I put a primer all over my face and I used a pore filling primer because I always do that and I wanted to give this foundation like the best chance possible. So that is what I did. The coverage is quite nice. It is quite light and very yellow. So I will be blending for a bit, but I will show you when I'm done how it looks. First off, let's go to my forehead. Normally, I have a lot of trouble with like foundation settling very quickly into my forehead lines. It's not doing that very much, so that's good. It does have a decent amount of coverage. As you can see, I have quite red cheeks and I think they're covered up really nicely. I must say that the dry down is quite matte already. It's already feeling very dry. It sits okay on my nose. I use a pore filling primer by Smashbox. It's my favorite and it's looking okay. It's not looking the best, I must say, the foundation. Not the best. I have seen smoother finishes on my like nose. And I have a feeling that once it dries down the foundation, you can't really blend anymore because it's just going to, you know, lift the product. So that is not something. I'm not blown away. Okay, I should have cleaned my number 5 brush. I didn't, I'm sorry. But I'm going into the face products and I'm going to start off with the bronzer. This is the Nabla Skin Bronzing in Ambra. And I think this is one of the lightest shades. The lightest, I think. I think it's the lightest. It's a very beautiful packaging. Look at this product, it's beautiful. I always have a feeling that Nabla is so chic, like that chic feeling, because they're Italian. They're an Italian brand, so I'm just swirling it in. Something happening? Yep. It's like a nice, kind of like cool toned color, and it looks a bit shiny in the pan, but more like a glowy shine, you know? Not like as if you are going to have a highlighty bronzer or something. What I do love about this is that it does show up a little, but it's not like ba-bam and you have too much on your face. I do like the color. It's not too red, which I am always a little bit like. But it also could be that it's not too red because the foundation is really yellow. So that could also be a thing. Because I do like it, but the foundation is throwing me off a little bit. Then I'm going in with the blush, and this is in the shade Lola. It's also a skin glazing product. It is also in that like beautiful clear plastic packaging, but the plastic is pink. This is also really glowy, and I am not a big fan of glowy blushes, so let's see if it's glowy or really just flattering. I'm going to take my Linda Hallaberg 310 brush. I love this brush. It's my favorite blush brush. Picks up nicely, and then I'm going to start up with the high point of my cheek. Well, there's already something happening, as you can see. Wow, I'm going to take it a little bit to the front to give my very yellow cheeks a little bit more life to it. It's really nice. Draping it a little bit to the back as well. Wow, it's really nice. I think I don't know if you can really see it that much on... Oh yeah, you can see it. You can see it. It's really nice, but it looks like very beautiful, like that flushed, but the flush from within. So it's not like, ooh, you went ham, girl. You went ham on your blush today? Did you love the blush today, babe? Yeah. It's not that. It's like very... It feels really natural. Really nice. Then the last thing, this is a skin glazing highlighter and it's in the shade Amnesia. I've had this for a very long time already. It is one of my favorite highlighters. I think I'm going to take my refer number 18 brush and I'm going to go in and just put it on the high points of my cheek. Really pretty, right? It's like that wet glow from within type of deal, and I love it, and it blends so beautifully. I have quite textured skin, especially when I put some powder on it, and this just really, it just performs, I can't speak into this, it performs really beautifully, even though it is a little bit like textured. Okay, I want to buff my face a little bit. I'm going to finish my under eye and then I will be back for the lips. I have 3 lip liners. These are the 1, 2, and 3. Ooh, they are really nice. I really like the packaging. I'm going to swatch them for you on my hand. And then I'm going to see which shade is the best with this dreamy creamy lip shade in Eve. All right, I'm going to swatch them all on my hand for you. This is number 1. Really beautiful. This is number 2, so this one. This is more like a brownie tone. Really beautiful. And that is number 3. It's a little bit darker, but it is a little bit warmer than those two, I would say. These two are a little bit more like cool toned. Right? Okay, and this is the lippy... What's it called? Dreamy Creamy, I think. Let me see. It's a liquid lipstick, but it's not... as I understand it, it's new for me. It's a new product for me. I've had their liquid lipsticks and they were way too drying. And these seem a little bit more like a soft matte. And this is the shade. I think I will pair the number 1 lip liner with the lippy. Because I think that's the best combination. I'm just saying, nude number 1. All right. I'm just going to line my lips. I'm not going to fill them in. I really like the formula. It's not too tuggy. It's not too dry, but it's not extremely creamy either. So I really love that. So you can get some precision out of the lip liners as well. I really do like that. Yeah, and the cap is really sturdy, so that is good. Okay, let's try this because I did not like the regular liquid lipsticks. Okay, just blotting it down a little with my finger. Well, the color is really beautiful. I really love this. This is in the shade Eve, I believe. Yes, this is the shade Eve. I will have it all down in the description box, of course. But I really like it. It has a little bit... Ooh, I'm feeling it now. It has a little bit, just like a hint. A hint of like a mintiness to it. It really feels creamy. But if you look at like... It has somewhat of a soft matte dry down. In conclusion, If I have to recommend you where you should start, I would totally say start with their eyeshadow palette. All of them are really beautiful. I know that the Poison Garden didn't get the most love, but I really do enjoy it. I think this one is really stunning as well. I love the shimmer formula. This is a beautiful formula. This one as well. This is the Starlight. Yeah, that one as well. Love those shades. I love the mattes. This one gave me a little bit of like, but I think that is just because, you know, it's always those type of colors that give me a little bit of problem. So I really love those, and I have always loved eyeshadow palettes by Nabla. So I think that is the safest way to go to start with Nabla. Closely followed, I feel, by their skin glazing formula. I really enjoyed each one of them, especially the highlighter and the blush. The bronzer I do like. I do like the effect. It looks really skin-like. I love it, but I have to see it on a better like color match to my face foundation, because that's the thing. Then in third place, if I have to say third place, it's just because it's a little less interesting to me, I would say the lip liners. They are really beautiful. I can't say anything about, like, you know, the staying power, but I try to really rub these off. Look at that. It's still, it takes me a little bit of an effort to take them off. So these are really stunning. I really love the colors. They are quite unique to my collection, because I have a lot of like, it always leans a little bit more pink, a lip liner, instead of like really nude. And these are really nude. And I think for my skin tone, these are beautiful colors, but they go up. 4, 5, and 6 are even darker. So I think there's something for, I think, almost everybody. Then I think after that, I love these Arrow eye pencils. These are eye and lip pencils. I only use them for the eye. The only thing I would say is a bit of a hassle is that the point is so stubby that you have to reach for an angled brush to make sure that you can make a tight or just a smaller line. That's a thing. But other than that, I love the color selection. I love the formula. It's really beautiful. So this is something I would totally recommend as well. And then in fifth place, this one. I really do love the look of this. I love the dry down. It's getting drier now. I think it is where it will stay right now. And I really do love it. The only thing, and that is something I don't mind, but maybe you mind, is that you can really see the texture of my lips. I don't think it's really aging my lips, but you can see the texture. I have a feeling though, it is really going to be very long lasting. I will leave a comment down below in the pinned comment telling you about, like, you know, the longevity of this one. Then, something I didn't really mention, but the two brushes I used to do the powder are both Nabla brushes. This is the Bon Mien brush, and I love this for under eye action. And this is the cheek shaper, this one. This is the cheek shaper, and these brushes are beautiful. I have been reaching for these every day since I got them. So these are totally big time recommend. The only thing I didn't fall in love with for now, like, because I really have to try the mascara, I have to try the powder, and I have to try concealer and brow stuff, so I'm not really done with Nabla yet, but this, it isn't the best. When I'm looking at it right now, I didn't put some setting spray on. Maybe I should. I think this is on for like an hour now. It looks a little bit better. It had the chance to melt with my skin a little bit, but it's a little better. But it emphasizes texture too much for me to really love and like it. So the foundation is the only thing I'm like, try a mini first if you really want to try their foundation. All right, ladies, that is it from me for today. If there's anything you want me to do in-depth videos on, if you want me to try more of Nabla, then please let me know. I will be so happy to do that. I love Nabla, as I said. So let me know down below what it is you still want to see. I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, then please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye.